to accept our alms and oblations and receive these our prayers, which we offer to thy divine mercy. Beseech you, may you inspire us to complete the universal church, the spirit of truth, unity, and power. Grant that all those who confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy comfort and live in unity and God's love. We beseech thee also so to direct and expose the hearts of all the schools, that they may truly and impartially minister justice, punish the wickedness and vice, and the maintenance of thy true religion and worship. Give grace for your Father to all bishops and all ministers, that they may both by their life and God set forth thy true life and glory, and justly and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people, give thy holy grace, and especially to this congregation in your presence, that with a meek heart and reverence, they may hear and receive thy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy grace, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who this transitory life are. suffered death on the cross for our union. Mary gave her life in oblation of himself on his offering, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and it instituted in his holy gospel for us to continue, a perpetual memory of that precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night of Jesus' betrayal, he took bread. And when he had given thanks and break, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to him, saying, "Drink, ye all of this. This is my blood, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you shall drink, in remembrance of me." Thank you.